talking, I thought it would be fun to have a discussion of Latin and ballroom similarities and dissimilarities. Competition dancing?
Or, yeah.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yes.
You don't want social dancing?
No.
I promised, how would you dance socially, let's say, Latin?
Socially?
Yeah. If I were going to, if you asked me to dance, we were at a club somewhere, let's say, a little rumba was playing, you know, tick, 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 tick,
what?
Tick, 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 ah.
Internet?
Well, I don't normally. No, social. We're at a club. We're at a club.
Oh, okay.
Can you believe Bill Davies is doing this? You'd expect that from me, but not
him.
You
believe Bill Davies can do this, huh? Now, that was interesting. You know what you just did? You did something interesting there. You bent your knee there.
I know.
It was rather comfortable.
Oh, wait. You know, this is no lie. This is really funny. I did a lecture at the Classique. You know, when you do these lectures, you get to dance with everyone, you know, like myself. And I have a picture blown up like this that Miriam sent me of dancing with Ron Montez. And then I danced with Kenny Welch, and I danced with Richard
I danced with
all the... I had the best. But unfortunately, I'm not a woman.
Well, after today, you can say you've had the best.
Yes. Right, after today.
What I thought interesting, just let me make a comment, because it was really, I think that you really feel great. What you just did there was super.
But what?
No buts. But what I noticed was that we, at this moment in time, me too, had this soft knee. You see, just do what you do. Dee, 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 dee. And what I wonder is that the amount of activity in space that we're accompanying right here might have something to do with the way I'm using my body and my knees. Now, if let's say you wanted to all of a sudden compete and you knew that I was the quick, responsive partner that I am.
Do you want me to do the... All right, I'm doing American Pie. Ah, I shouldn't. Ready?
You do what you want, baby. I can follow anything.
There is a point.
See, the point is, can I say a point?
You go right ahead.
When I think of competition dancing, all right, you are now dancing for the audience, the judge, whatever. So to me, everything becomes three-dimensional so that you can bring these eyes to look at you. All right? To me, the competition dancing and the straightening of the leg and all this is it's very bold, it's very aggressive looking, compared to, I think that's what happens to American style sometimes. They're trying to get a very bold and aggressive look, and this, to me, you know what I'm going to say, tends to bring me down and earthy. I don't feel like doing this when I'm being three-dimensional. I think if American style would have stayed the way, I know how you feel about this, but I mean, if it would have just stayed very natural and easy and didn't make competition all of a sudden bring you up to this.
You mean the way we use our body for the purpose should have effect on the way we look. If we are using our bodies and our minds to compete and to win prizes, to be better than anyone else, that should affect our behavior. But if we're at a club,
I always knew it. I knew someday he'd come out of the closet for me. And all that stuff.
I had a dream. I had a dream.
He had a dream. He had a dream. Don't anyone buy this tape. The NDCA will throw us out.
Of course, well, we're out. Yeah. I was out earlier, but not only of the NDCA, out of the Imperial, out of, you know, they're all, psh, get rid of him. He's crazy. Anyway, so now, if let's say I was at a club and Sam was dressed in a different way, and a foxtrot came about. Well, would you like to dance?
Yes.
Oh, are you sure? If you can. You're beautiful.
I'm the worst girl in the world because I want to take over.
I know. Lucky I'm such a strong leader. Here we are. Competition time comes. My partner isn't speaking to me. We know why after today.
Marina would love this for her next television.
What can we learn from that?
The ripple.
Do you know what was really quite outstanding about what Sam did in that those heel turns with the ripple in the various places? Not once did he disturb my balance.
So eat your heart out.
Not once did he impose his desire.
First of all, I like them younger, so forget it. But anyway.
Am I blushing? Yeah, look.
But not, he did not in any way interfere with the general progression of our weight moving across the floor together. This was true in the social as well as in the competitive mode. Pardon me?
He's a good dancer.
He's a good dancer. That's true. That is probably the one of the important qualities that you, when you say, boy, I like dancing with her, like dancing with him,
It's because they don't impose their weight or physical pressure on one another. Yes?
Right.
Okay.
That's what I was talking about today, when you think, keep thinking of relaxed muscles and dancing through your bones and not on your muscles. I mean, if I can do a ripple on a heel turn, that means my body...
What do you do an outside spin, Sam?
I can do it. But that means if I... I'm not on the modern now, but if I do a heel turn... Now, don't look at my damn feet. Everyone goes... I'm going to go real quick. But I'm very relaxed here, which means, you know, I'm not like this. Which means my body is so nice and easy, and I'm in my... So, which gives me the time that I can do this if I want. Which means you don't want a...
Do you mean to say...
That I'm just relaxed. That's all I wanted to...
That if we were competing in the Roomba...
Yes.
And you put me out into a fan...
I love the attitude.
That I should be able to move around without interfering in any way with your weight.
Right.
Oh.
I want the girl to go out there in a fan, okay, and hit this here, and I want it very relaxed, so that I don't want it like this. I always say that my girl should be able to ripple if I wanted her to. That's how relaxed. I mean, I don't want it to go like that. But it should be that easy all the time.
You don't want it to go like that?
Like that? Like that.
God, no. I mean, just think if you did a heel turn like that.
Right. Why do you think people... Can I ask you a question?
You just did.
Okay. Why do you think a lot of people think power... Power means that they have to make their muscles look like they're doing something in there. Why does power have to come from working the muscles? Why do people think that sometimes?
Well, it does have to come from using the muscles, whether it be the brain or whatever physical behavior you want to talk about. But I think what you're talking about
now,
is...
showing the... Yeah, like this. If I'm going to do... Here we go again, folks. If I'm going to do... A fan. I mean, a walk. He's got one, too. Oh.
I have a question.
We haven't answered the question. Now, wait. I want to answer the question.
What
you
when you were a coach for the
GK? You ought to know. Becky's still trying to pass off that she's under 40. How many of you have been around, like the two of us?
Well, she is. She's only a few years older than me.
The thing is...
In answer to your question...
Why do
I
want to
think,
see that?
Well, I think people don't understand how, one, to get power... And two, how to use it. And so...
Like a feather.
They're struggling. Do a feather.
And tell me how you get that power to...
Uh-huh. There's only one way that I can get power that I know about. Besides the thought... No, first, I must have the desire. I must want to. Second of all, I must understand how to. And third, I must do. Now, I know that if we were angry at one another and we were going to fight...
But I want to make love. No! Come here. Yes?
Push me. Push me, baby.
Oh, no! The other way!
I know that I must have a connection with the floor. It's a friction surface, a surface of friction to press against. Now, with that, I could be very strong. I could use the power in a bad way. I could push and land poorly. Once I've pushed my weight in some way, I've got to catch it. If I don't catch it, I fall. So the catch becomes equally important to the push, I think. What do you think?
I think. Well, you know, when I always do Latin, the biggest thing for me was always right through here. I never took a step without...
I could feel that.
Yeah. It's really weird. The 31 years I've done Latin, I have always concentrated on from here to here. So it's very difficult, and I'll be the first one to admit it. For years, I never thought of feet and legs. I mean, everything was through here. I mean, if I danced, it was all through this kind of thing. Then when I started doing competition dancing, people started bringing me, use your feet, use your legs, do this. But I still tried to incorporate the thing that I like to do the most was always through here.
Do you get couples that come to you for coaching and you might characterize them by saying, boy, you really look spaced out.
Uh-huh.
When you dance, you look really spaced out. I get them, you know. I get couples that will come in, they'll stand up, good-looking couples, young, physically, you know, strong, coordinated. Now, I don't know, in Latin, do you get them?
Mm-hmm.
I think that comes from losing connection with the floor. Trying to desperately move in some way without that little pressure. Even this.
Yeah.
There must be something here that is feeding all that those muscles. But you know, we walk so, you know, you ever watch a baby walk? What's it doing when it first starts? Crash! Oh. What's happening? It's fighting gravity. There's this force. And then it wins. And then pretty soon it learns the mobility. Strength, push, catch, strength, push, catch, strength, push, catch, strength. I think sometimes we forget to catch, push. So we shouldn't push then.
Mm-hmm. I think in the Latin, the more I keep seeing it, the more I keep watching it, the less, I'm not talking about material now, the less, the better. The more that you can just, taking it from day one where you're just a regular walk, just doing nothing. I mean, sometimes people look like they're not even enjoying what they're doing, but they are doing what they think they were told, and they look like they're in pain. They don't look like they're having fun because they look like what they were told to do looks uncomfortable. I mean, from what I'm watching. And sometimes I think that something goes... I'm a great one. When I see something different, I go right to the source. When Latin at one time was being danced, well, I called it a bell action. Everything was a swing. Now, you're coming from a guy who did Latin like this all the time, right? All of a sudden, the Latin trend is going, they're swinging like this, like a bell. And I ask questions right away, because when you judge a lot, you get to be around all these people. And really what they wanted was not the bell, but they wanted the squeezing of the side, and somehow this came all to be.
No, they wanted the bell.
Yeah.
They did. They did. You know the confusion again. Do that bit that you just did here.
Oh.
Deep, deep. Ah, yeah, okay. Deep, bon. Keep doing that. Yeah, deep, deep, bon. What are we doing? What are we doing here?
Our bodies are talking to each other.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh.
Yes, they are. Where would we be doing that?
Oh. I guess in bed.
Where?
Where?
We'd be out social dancing.
Oh, by the way, I thought sexual. I'm sorry.
Well, we know you. Farthest thing from my mind.
Social dancing. Now, the bell. What was that?
I don't know.
Competition dancing. Remember when we first went to England? Remember the competitors?
Yes.
So funny, and we said, what are they doing? They look so weird. They had funny music, mind you. What was the popular tune of the day, right?
Popcorn. Whatever that was.
Popcorn. T for two, cha-cha. Yeah. Do you remember that? Do you remember how to do that?
No.
Remember? Remember?
See, we had to go all through this. Now a cha-cha lock is like this.
Do it the old way, Sam.
Do it the old way. Here we go. Do you remember it? Do you remember it?
Do you want to dance with me? Oh, I can't even. I never did it that way. You're used to bounce. He does that well.
I want to tell you something that I guess it was Rudy Trouts did that, won the British.
That's who told you.
Now, while Rudy was doing that, winning the British, Sam and Pat Ogan were doing ha-dum-dee-ha-ta-ta, dee-ta-ya-ta-tum, pa-pa, ya-ta-ta-pam-pa. They didn't win the British. Vernon and Bev didn't win the British. Right? But the British took every ounce of sensation, right? Said, hey, there's something there. Got hold of the music, changed the music, changed the behavior. Next time out, let's see, where did we get to? After Trouts, Opitz.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what have we got today? What do we got today? Donnie Burns and Gaynor Fairweather. We got Michael Jackson and his sister or something, or who knows, you know, but I mean. And what do? We reject it. We say that isn't American. We know what American is, when in fact American is winning the British. But we lost the recognition. We gave it away.
That was the truest, yeah, you know, very, very clever.
In our lust to have something special and apart because of our fear that we can't compete with the rest of the world, we gave away what we had. Did it in VCRs, automobiles, and Latin.
Right. I mean, I think it's funny today when a lockstep is being done. I mean, I'm not funny, because I've always, when you're doing two, three, and you're coming through here and you're getting four, and one, two, three, and you're getting all this hip action now, compared to ya-ti-ta. I mean, this is what we had to deal with. And now they're all doing with the hips.
You know what I see in the samba? I see Donnie Burns. I think ti ta. What is that? They're doing mambo. What we call mambo. Where did he get it?
America. American style.
American style is winning the British.
Haven't you noticed the difference? I don't know, because you're all dancing and you're all around the international. Haven't you noticed the difference in jive? Maybe you haven't, but jive used to be very, it's this, until Donnie Burns went to West Coast and started seeing all this other influence. And now everything, I mean, it makes me laugh when I see them doing this. And jive, jive is always...
Mm-hmm. You actually like what is being danced.
Where did the word jive come from?
Half and half.
Where did the word jive come from? World War II, England, American blacks in the English clubs, jiving with the English girls. Hey, let's go. Let's dance all night. Da-dum.
jive. Hey, those Americans, they really jive, don't they? That's where it came from. What's going on? Power. You asked about power. Mm-hmm. Where do we get power and how do we use it?
Are you asking me?
Yes.
Oh. No, I'm thinking of something like when you do your foxtrot.
Yeah?
I find that a very lovely dance. I mean, I find all your dances lovely. But I'm thinking of softness right now.
Yeah.
I keep getting back to the thing of making it look like Latin and ballroom. Like, can you take Rebecca for a minute?
She'll let me. If she'll let me. Will you let me?
Will you let me take you?
I saw a demonstration one time, but we can't do it because it's not rehearsed.
We haven't heard.
They played a foxtrot, and a couple did the foxtrot, and at the same time, the Latin couple did the rumba. Okay?
We use rumba music?
Yes.
Rumba music.
And the point I'm trying to get across, this whole thing, is that foxtrot effortless, relaxed, nothing, don't work to produce a movement. And so easy to say, but like what Bill said, if you have the basic principles of all that, and you understand what you want. The thing I want to keep stressing here is that competition dancing doesn't mean the minute you go on the floor that you have to produce this effort because you want to be seen. I think sometimes, well, not sometimes.
Well, you got to produce the effort, but it shouldn't be seen.
Right. I'll tell you something about Billy and Shirley, which made me laugh, and you're gonna, I really laugh at this. They don't mind me saying this. One day, I looked at them dancing their five routines. And they took the music off and I said, what in the hell are you doing? They said, well, they said, we're trying to dance effortless. I said, you're trying to dance effortless? Well, you're putting me to sleep with what you just did. I said, effortless comes from when your muscles are so trained to just make it look like it's effortless. But to go out on the floor and say, well, I'm going to dance effortless now. It becomes dead. Now, here's the train. We're only talking a month ago. All right? You're looking at a couple who's getting there, and they're getting established. But you see, someone's got to be there to police them. Do you see what I mean when I said I police them? Now, if I wasn't there, they would have went on their program all this a month before a competition thinking effortless in their mind. Well, I'm going to dance effortless. The next competition they go to, their results become nothing because in their mind, see, it's very important to have someone there to say you're going the wrong way with your thinking.
If you were a British champion, could you get out on the floor and be effortless?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
We're
going to
do basic, but the very main point is...
We're going to do basic.
That's always.
If we don't like it, we'll stop.
Okay.
Now, my point is, and that's all I'm going to say, my whole thing...
Well, we have one other thing to really discuss about this.
What?
Really important. The musical interpretation that you were using when that music was playing, can you describe it?
Of dancing with her and her sisters?
Yes.
while that music was playing. I want to see what the similarities are musically.
Okay, I have a funny interpretation when I dance.
You do?
Yes.
Somehow I knew that. Let me take Mambo for example.
No, let's take what you just
okay.
did.
I try to go as slow as possible.
So do I.
No, really, in my mind. Number one, that I used to challenge myself. I would go get, that's why I said Mambo. I would go get a Mambo, get the fastest record possible, and go out there and try to make it look like I wasn't doing a damn thing. Meanwhile, that music was challenging me to go fast.
What was it like inside while you were trying to go slow?
What? Turmoil.
Do you know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? No, seriously, now, you just said you wanted the fastest mambo you could find so you could challenge yourself to go as slow as possible within the context of
right.
an appropriate time. So you're not out of time.
Right, oh yeah.
Right. Now, what was it like inside while you were doing that? Inside yourself.
Inside myself?
Yeah. I mean, like, was there struggle?
Oh, no, it wasn't a struggle because that's the way I was dancing within.
Relaxed
with compact within.
Can you imagine yourself doing it?
Yeah.
Can you do it?
Mm-hmm.
Do it.
I feel like I'm on
candid camera.
It's like everything became this way right away to me.
What does that feel like right now? That. What does that feel like?
Down with
down, tone. Contracted.
Contracted.
Muscles tight. Tone.
Tone. Tone.
Right. Really tone.
Into
right.
The floor, all the weight going. Pressure going.
Yeah. Okay.
I feel like I'm on the couch with a psychiatrist. You know what I mean? Quick. Are you trying to find my problem all these years? It's too late, but here.
Wait till you get his bill, Sam.
I know.
All right, so let's get... No, seriously, now you got your weight connected where? To where? Floor?
Floor.
The floor. You got it there. You got all the muscles ready to go. Now go. Right. Do it. Deep. That was good, Sam. Yeah. Now, basically, it's the same thing I'm doing. Funny.
Right.
Funny. You know, that music's going tick, 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 and then there's this funny thing called melody, which makes me go, oh, yeah. Oh, I feel, I feel, I feel, I feel. I don't look so good, but I feel, I feel.
That's right.
Man, wait a minute. Behavior counts in this game. We're trying to find what is the most appropriate behavior. Oh, so I got to feel, I got to get my weight connected down through my foot. I've got to get everything aligned inside. So the moment I start to move, I've got control over each step, each sense of weight. I've got to bring it on, push it off, catch it. Stand on it, move it down through, connect it to the floor, lift it up, bring it on. Same thing, isn't it?
That's the point I meant. You have to have someone older. He's more experienced than I am. I used to look up to him when I was a kid. He was my idol.
Sam, in the minds of all of us sitting here,
yes.
He definitely said, don't push off that foot. In the minds of all of us sitting here, we've all heard Bill say, push off that foot.
Yeah. Now, I'm glad you brought that up. Because Sam and I were talking about this. What Sam was saying, and this happens a lot. I do it. Sam does it. The great coaches of the world do it. I know one in particular that does it a lot. And in my opinion, because he does it a lot, it causes a lot of damage. They don't trust the pupil. Now, Sam doesn't like this. Am I right?
Right.
He hates that. I don't like it. I think when I see somebody, you know, it's awkward, clumsy, ugly. Tell me if I'm correct.
Right.
What he wants to avoid is people pushing into that leg. Just like on a feather step, I want people to stop pushing into their legs and going across like that. I mean, that looks silly, doesn't it? It looks awkward, clumsy. We're back to the use of power. in his mambo, he's gaining the power so he can catch. Look at that beautiful catch. That lovely way of catching that weight. You don't see him go, whoa. You know, he got it all together and then he beautifully caught that. If I'm swinging a feather step, right? My catch right here coming up, this has to be delicate, light, easy, supported, so I can stand on it. The moment I push myself across my foot, dead. And I think that's what you meant, isn't it?
See, when I look at you do that, I don't, even though if someone used the word push, I don't see him pushing. When he did that feather step, do that again.
Can you both, you do a rumba walk, Bill do a feather.
And three. Because it's we need those, yes. Are you ready?
Yes.
I'm going to go at your pace. Because you're not supposed to flight, and I am.
Okay. So we're going to do, yes.
Go ahead.
And.
You want to do them backwards? You want
to?
You want to? You want to do them? You want to do them backwards?
Thank you.
We're good, huh?
Mm-hmm.
We ought to do this more often. Should we ask if there are any questions? We have 10 more minutes. Yes, darling, yes.
Sam, when you talked about the weight change and everything in the rumba, and you talked about using the hips as a power base and catching your weight with your hips and not dropping and raising. And Bill, when you do a feather step, can you sort of give a parallel?
Well, the problem is, and I hear this a lot, and this is what we're talking about, and I think that we have a responsibility to try and bring out in the open as much truth as we can and accuracy, which is an evolving process. You see, one of the problems with ballroom people is they want to stay stuck in the past somewhere. They don't update themselves to the new knowledge that's available. Hips, for example. It is true that the hip is an important part of the physique, but you can only work it from a levering point on the floor. If you were in space, unconnected to anything that had friction, for a while you could probably move them, but you would lose the ability to move them because the muscle deterioration and tendon deterioration would come about from the lack of pressure and stress against us, or me if I was there. So there would be no muscle promotion. So whatever we do in motion, we must have a connection to the floor, except perhaps blinking our eyes. That's an involuntary action which I don't think needs a friction surface to have happen.
Well, Barbara, where's Barbara? What did you see when he did the...
It was absolutely wonderful how you still had where people see push or swing or so-called push when you were, Bill did this, Bill didn't push next, you saw this part of the body follow through, and you both were doing, it was brilliant, it was wonderful.
Yes. I must say something about ballroom that I'm coming across, which I think is a mistake. And that is that people are, instead of using the floor as a connection point to move their weight, leaning to move. Now, I could conceive slightly at a moment somewhere in the downward portion of the swing on to the next that you might give up your connection, but I think it's a mistake. I can see it happening, but I think it's a mistake to do it. And a lot of people are doing it. They're leaning their way across the floor. Now, if you do that, your body parts are going to separate. If your body parts are going to separate, you're going to balance because the human being wants to balance. What is not non-balanced mean? Falling down, dead, on the floor. That's unbalanced. This is still balanced. Anything like this is balanced, as long as it is in some way supported. May not be attractive, but it's balanced. Now, the moment that you give up balance, body parts are going to change automatically. We're built that way because we don't want to fall. We want to protect the brain. So anything, the edge of a pool, somebody nudges you. People say your hips shouldn't be out. Why shouldn't they be out? You know, if we're running and I put my hips under, I saw some people dancing that way. What we need is the best efficient mobility that we have and then move it in a confident way. Now, would you agree with that in rumba? I think in rumba people are told, lose your balance and catch it. Mm-hmm. Maybe that's the point you're talking about. Do you agree with it?
No, because I never feel like when I'm dancing that I'm doing that. But yet, a lot of people use that as an example. But yet, when I'm dancing, I don't feel like I'm doing this, and all of a sudden, I'm catching myself. I think it's just a way of telling people to have their poise forward constantly.
Of what?
Forward of what? Over the balls of their feet.
When?
All the time.
Take a step forward. Stop. Raise your weight.
For me?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, see, but remember, I don't teach that. You want to know something? This is so funny. Can you stand there?
I think so.
Now, when I do a fan and rumble walks and I come through, all right, when I step, all right now I feel like I could do this, all right? I never have my weight to the point where it's over on the balls of the feet and my heels are never lowered. I'm overdoing this. I mean, you know. But I did a seminar one time about 5 years ago in California, and the top couples in the country were there. And I'll mention the names. Chris and Denise Mars, everyone, Nick and Debbie, they were all there. I was the first, they said, I started teaching rumba walks. And I started saying, I would like, as you come through, to have your weight, the weight of your hip, towards your heel, not to this here, but the feeling of this, and that every time you came through, you felt that the weight was here. They were all doing this. This is no lie. They were on the balls of their feet doing this. Now, they mastered the look, because you would never have known it. I said to them, how the heck can you dance like that? They said, no one ever told us to lower our heel. And they were going on, I swear to God.
Where did they get it from?
Mind you, they came walking in to the studio this way.
I mean, we all know Chris and Denise Fox, right? We've seen them. I swear to you, she stood there and she said, no one ever told me to lower my heel. I said, how the heck can you dance rumba or anything always on the ball of your feet? Well, it's the same thing in the samba. When people do this votafogo and they come here, some of them never lower, I don't know how they do it, some of them never lower that heel, and they come through.
Why do they do it is my question.
Yeah. I mean, I see it all the time.
Do you know, I think the pupils think that we're some kind of gods, And that if we say you should do something, that means they should do it without any question in their own minds, without any sense of their own being in experiences, and just automatically. You know, if I said, I bet I could probably find a quite well-marked, high-up professional couple, and I could probably say, you know what, next competition, if you do this the whole way through, you're gonna be marked first. And I'll bet you that the whole way through you'd see that. They, you know, pupils have a responsibility to themselves to use their intelligence and their understanding of their own self and body and how to move it best and what's most attractive for them. Don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
Ah. I think so.
I call some coaches Draculas. I see some coaches take all the blood or the soul or the spirit sometimes out of a couple, and everything is gone and they're doing exactly what that coach said and everything else is just...
I know.
And Billy and Shirley will tell you one thing. I never, ever, ever, ever tell them, you know, that they've got to do it this way or feel it that way. Remember, I started my lecture saying that I never say this is the only way to do it. I think when you have an open mind like that and you leave that with your pupil to experiment with that, but when you tell your pupil all the time that this is the only way to do it and that's the way they're going to do it, and meanwhile, if you're like me, you go to a competition or somewhere and you can see they're doing something different. I can see when a change comes. For example, Samba, there was one time people were doing crisado walks like this. They were coming through, contracting like this in the center, coming through and doing this. So they were going ta-ta, 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 ta-ta. I go and judge the World Amateur Latin in Montreal. I'm the U.S. judge. I'm sitting there. And in my mind, crisado walks are like this. Ta-ta, 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 ta-ta. And I'm looking at these top Latin couples. I'm going, they're not doing it the way I'm teaching it. So the opportunity of talking to a lot of coaches, this is what they're doing now. But you got to... Like, you know, what did you say? You can never stifle your... What did you say? You always should be learning.
Evolving.
Evolving.
We are evolving. The question is how.
Right. Now, a crusado walk begins. You come here. You do this. As your weight goes onto that foot, the leg straightens. Okay? This foot starts to straighten. There's no more this. This leg starts to straighten. This comes here, and you get that. So it's all instead of pump, 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 pump. Now, I'm looking at this, and I'm doing it this way. They're using their size, and I saw it because I'm very aware. I don't know if in the ballroom, when you see things changing, and you know you're not doing what they're...
Yes.
But you like what they're doing.
Yes. Then I change.
Right. Oh, someone.
Do you know what the latest change in the foxtrot is that I like?
What?
Breaking on two. Yeah. You probably didn't notice it. When we danced, when Amy played the rumba. But I danced on the two. I knew that Sam would be dancing one, then a two, and three, and four, right? Could we do that again? I'll do it alone, Beck. That's okay. Because you just do it alone. No, no, no. You did it. You were beautiful. You were absolutely fabulous.
It seems like, I know in sport, with the athletes, they have to have all the technology. They're trying to make the motion follow the natural movement of the body.
Right, that's the way it works.
Injury and this sort of thing. And it seems to me that ballroom is going to have to keep evolving in that same direction where the movement is more natural to the movement and the stance of the body rather than forcing it into these positions that are not natural that you learn by practicing.
And we've been...
Well, the ones that are winning are already doing that.
And we've been through all these positions.
Yeah. but here, if you notice, one and a two and three, you're doing rumba, right? Five and six and seven, eight, oh, one and a two, three, four, five and six and seven, eight, oh, one, two, three, four, six, seven, eight. Do it again. You're going to break on the two. Break right foot on the two. Right foot on the two. Is it synced? We have to finish. So that what this lady brought up is extremely important. The human body has evolved through many, many long processes of survival. We have a wonderful machine. It is for the sake of survival that it is we are the way we are. We are the most able species on Earth. To do something that changes our machinery is a great mistake in terms of efficiency and the ability to do. What the problem is insecurity. The feeling of not being good enough. To overcome that, we many times overcompensate. Instead of the acceptance that we are good enough and that if we study our work and know it well, we will succeed. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great.
That was good. Thank you. I know. You know, I just want to do one thing. Could you put a box run on? Come on.
Sam
hey,
wants to
I've
be
never
been.
Seen ladies before I do. Just do leave me in anything.
Anything?
No, basic. Whatever you want.
Separated it. It was dancing. It was just good dance. Thanks so much.
Thank you.